the Stooky will curse the day somebody named him Oliver.
Assistance! Lock him up, collect his belongings, and bring him back to me when you're done. To bed, all of you! Assistance!
Clean up these tables!
Yes, you're quite right, Mrs. Courtney. We must get rid of this canker in our midst. That boy was born to be hung, Mrs. Courtney. I've never been so shocked in all my days.
Hush, Mr. Bumble. You must have had quite a turn. Sit down and have a nice cup of tea.
It's nice to be appreciated, Mrs. Courtney. But these here paupers in this here parish don't appreciate me. Auntie parochial they are, ma'am. Auntie parochial. Why, we have given away a matter of 20 loaves and a cheese and a half this very blessed afternoon. And still them paupers is not contented.
Of course they are not. When would they be? Sweet, Mr. Bumble?
Very sweet indeed, ma'am.
You little tinker, you!
You have a cat, I see, ma'am. And kittens, too, I declare.
Oh, I'm so fond of them, Mr. Bumble. You can't imagine. And they're fond of their own, too.
Mrs. Courtney, ma'am, I must say that any cat or kitten that could live with you, ma'am, and not be fond of its own, must be an idiot, ma'am, and don't deserve to live in it.
Oh, Mr. Bumble!
It's no use disguising facts, ma'am. An idiot! I would drown it myself! With pleasure!
Then you're a cruel man! A very hard-hearted man at all!
Hard? Hard-hearted? You hard-hearted, Mrs. Courtney?
Dear me! What a very curious question coming from a single man. What can you want to know for? Mr. Bumble, I should
scream! So you would pay him if I wanted something special, then you couldn't say you. Did I nearly catch you smiling? Yes, I did. It's beguiling. If your hand is close, I'll press it. Yes, you like it, I'll confess it. Yes, you do.
No, I don't!
Yes, you do.
I shall scream. Till they hasten to my rescue, I shall scream.
Since there's nobody that's near us, you could see us or could hear us. If I ask you, can I kiss you? Say, what will I pretty miss you?
I shall scream, scream, scream!
If I pinch you one inch from your shy protective shell, and I inch you one inch, will my blossom box of beauty let a sitter do his duty? Though it's lapping very large, dear, sit upon it, there's no charge, dear, will you sit?
No, I shan't!
Will you sit?
I shall scream! For the safety of my virtue, I shall scream! Though you may as rather cozy see my cheeks and get lousy!
Scream!
You're not a bad man if you think I can't be proper, grim and haughty. I can, and you'll pardon if I mention you must state your true intention.
Is there booked another room here?
No.
If there were a bride and groom here, would there be?
Well, there might.
We shall see.
I shall scream at the thought
don't wonder where the scream went when we come to an agreement. Yes, my lovey-dovey's chubby, could she love a chubby hubby?
I shall scream, Mr. Bumble! I shall scream, Bumble Bumble! I shall scream! Scream! Scream!
I brought the boy, ma'am.
You would! Get a good price for him, Mr. Bumble!
He's going cheap. Only 7 guineas least, that or thereabout. Small boy, rather pale, through lack of sleep, feeding through well dinners, stop it getting stale. If I should say he wasn't very greedy, I could not, I'd be telling you a tale. Small boy, rather pale, I'll take a peep. Have you ever seen as nice a boy for sale?
Liberal terms, Mr. Sourberry.
Liberal terms? £5!
Well, as a matter of fact, I was needing a boy.
Good.
Then it's settled.
£5, please.
If you don't mind, cash upon liking, Mr. Bumble. Cash upon liking.
Mrs. Sourberry!
What?
Will you have the goodness to come here for a moment, my dear?
What do you want? Well, what is it?
I have told Mr. Bumble.
Hello, Mr. Bumble.
Hello, Mrs. Sourberry.
I have told him that we may consider taking in this boy to help in the shop.
Dear me. He's very small.
Yes, he is rather small. There's no denying it, but he'll grow. He'll grow.
Ah, I dare say he will, on our victuals and our drink. They're a waste of time, these workhouse boys. They always cost more to keep than what they're worth. Still, you men always think you know best. What are you going to do with them?
Well, there's an expression of melancholy on his face, my dear, which is very interesting. He could make a delightful coffin follower.
A what?
Well, I have been the regular coffin follower, as will follow grown-ups, but for the children's practice. Nice to have a follower in proportion, my sweet. A suburb effect. I think about it.
For once, just for once, you might have a decent idea. Very well then, boy, what's your name?
Oliver. Oliver Twistman.
A singular name.
I'm having one of my own choosing.
Yours, Mr. Bumble?
Mine, Mrs. Sourberry.
How's that, Mr. Bumble?
The boy's mother came to us destitute. Brings the child into the world, takes one look at him, and promptly dies without leaving so much as a forwarding name and address.
Dear, dear. Well, Oliver Twist, do you think you could look like that gentleman?
Right, Henry. These things must be done proper and correct. Henry, get us the top hat. Henry!
Really?
It takes you twice as long to do anything as anyone else. Yes? Yes. Can you hold that expression for a long time, boy, with a crowd watching you?
Yes, ma'am. I think so.
He's a born undertaker's mute. I can see him wearing a black silk suit, following behind the funeral procession, with his features fixed on a suitable expression.
That's your funeral.
There'll be horses with tall black plumes to escort us to the family tombs. There'll be mourners in all corners who've been taught to weep in tune.
That's your funeral.
Then the coffin lined in satin, large enough to wear your hat in.
That's your funeral.
We're just here to glamorize you for that endless sleep.
You might just as well look fetching when you're 6 feet deep.
And the wake will drink a toddy to the body beautiful. That's your funeral.
Not our funeral.
That's your funeral.
Yes, that's your funeral.
If you're fond of overeating, starve yourself by undereating.
That's my funeral.
That's your funeral.
Visualize the earth descending on you, clawed by clawed. You can't come back when you're buried underneath the sod.
We will not reduce our prices. Keep your vice as usual.
That's your funeral.
Not our funeral.
That's your funeral.
Yes, that's your funeral.
I don't think this verse is funny.
There's the boy. Now where's my money?
That's your funeral.
No, that's your funeral.
We don't harbor thoughts macabre. There's no need to frown.
In the end, we'll either burn you up or nail you down.
We love coughs and wheezes and diseases called incurable.
Not our funeral.
No one else's funeral. That's
your funeral. Very well, then. Boy, that's your job. Junior coffin follower. Have you eaten?
No, ma'am. Not since I...
Charlotte!
What?
Charlotte!
What?
Bring up some of the cold bits we put out for the dog. It hasn't been in all day, so it can go without them. Charlotte, love, this is the new boy. Give them to him. Have you done?
Yes, ma'am.
I'm glad to hear it. Get to bed, Henry. Come on, Charlotte, don't just stand there gawking. Now then, Oliver Twist, you're missed by the coffins. You don't mind sleeping among coffins, I suppose. But it doesn't much matter whether you do or don't. You can't sleep nowhere else.
Thank you.
Lock the door! Open that door!
I will directly, sir.
Are you the new boy?
Yes, sir.
How old are you?
13, sir.
Then I'll walk you home when I get in. You'll just see if I don't, you little walkout brat.
Did you knock, sir?
I did.
Did you roll the coffin, sir?
No, but you'll be wanting one before very long if you start cheating your superiors. Now open that door. You don't know who I am, I suppose, Walkhouse.
No, I can't say as I do.
I'm Mr. North Claypool, and you're underneath. So shut that door, you ugly young scallywag.
Well, hello, Noah. I saved some nice bits of bacon for you for Pastor's breakfast.
Oliver, get over there and eat them bits of your tea. And make haste, because I want you to mind the shop later. Do you hear?
Do you hear? Walk out.
Oh, Lord, Noah, what a tease you are. Let the boy alone.
Let him alone. I give the boy a chance, you silly. Everyone lets him alone. Father let him alone. His mother let him alone. Everyone let him alone. Except for dear old kind old noise.
Oh, you are a woman.
Walkout, how's your mother?
You leave my mother out of this. She's dead.
What did she die of, Walkout? Shortage of breath?
Never you mind.
Oh, but I do mind.
Well, you better not say any more. See?
Better not. Better not if you don't mind. Cheek of it. The Walkout's cheek of it. My mother, he said. She was a nice one, she was. You know, Walkout, it can't be helped now. And of course, it couldn't be helped then. And I'm very sorry for it and all that. But you must know, Walkout, your mother was a regular, right down, bad.
What did you say?
A regular, right down, bad. And it's a good thing she died when she did, or she had to go hard labor in prison, as naked as not. You murder me! Scarlet!
What's going on?
This here new boy's a murderer, me!
What
How about this one? He's gone mad!
Coming, Noah!
Scarlet!
Oh, rat!
Noah, get help! Charlotte, some water, quick!
My dear, she's going off.
Oh, Charlotte! Oh, Charlotte! We could have all been murdered in our midst! Ah! Harkin, help us! I want to have drink! I drink! Oh, Charlotte, what's to be done?
Oh, I don't know, Mother. Unless we send for the Bow Street Brothers.
The beer.
Mr. Bumble. Oh, Mr. Bumble.
Where is he? Dead?
Very much alive.
Oliver!
You let me out of here!
Do you know this here voice, Oliver?
Yes.
And ain't you afraid of it, Oliver?
No.
Ain't you a trembling while I speak, Oliver?
No! Of course! The boy is insane, Mr. Bumble! No boy in half his senses could venture to speak so to you!
It's not madness, madam. It's, meat.
What?
Meat, madam, meat. You overfed him, madam. You breaks the artificial spirit of the boy, unbecoming of his station in life. If you'd have kept him on the road, this would never have happened.
Dear, dear, this is what comes of being generous.
Ah, yes, indeed. The only thing that can be done now, that I know of, is for me to take him back for a couple of days.
I'll keep him out of room. He comes of a bad family.
What's going on in my parlor?
That boy, Oliver, you have no idea what he's been up to. We had to lock him up. Never in all my life have I seen such behavior.
Now, you're a nice young fellow. Anchor!
He called my mother names! Well, and what if he did, you ungrateful little wretch? She probably deserved what was said. And worse.
She did it!
She did! It's a lie!
He's gone!
£5 of mine run off! Well, after him, go, after my brother, after him!
Consider yourself
one of the family.
Wait, I hear so strong. It's clear we're going to get to the concert yourself. When then, concert yourself. Part of the furniture. There is a lot to spare. Who cares what ever we got to share? There's a chance that maybe we should see some paradise. Empty paradise.
Why grass?
Or's a chance we'll need somebody to foot the bill. Then the drinks are on the ass. Consider yourself our might. We don't have no fuss. For after some consideration, we can state. Consider yourself one of us. Consider yourself.
That go.
Consider yourself
one of the family.
Wait.
So strong.
It's clear we're
going to get along.
Consider yourself.
Wedding.
Consider yourself.
Hide the furniture.
Comes to call. Consider yourself our might. We don't have no fuss. For